think first and foremost, it's got to be somebody who is passionate about their job. And for me, the job is the students, the kids. So it's somebody who's driven by that connection with the kids and making sure that they do everything that they can to make sure every kid experiences success.
For me, it's the relationship building. It's the recipe that starts it all. It is the fact that they have to trust me, I have to trust them. We have to find a connection that we can stand on so that everybody is safe to learn.
You can teach them about science, you can teach them about math or whatever you want to teach them, but if you don't have their connection and they don't think they care about you or you care about them, they're never gonna do anything for you. So getting that connection with them and letting them know that you care about them is really what makes a great teacher.
Sometimes that teacher is the only stability that a child has. They're the only person that a child's going to see every single day, and they can count on that teacher. And so dependability and compassion.
What makes a teacher special is when a teacher is really able to understand you and actually seems like they are really involved in the work that you've put forward in their class, or that they really want to help you succeed in any and all fronts possible.
I love my teacher because she's brave, smart, and talented.
It was a journey that I never expected, but I'm glad that I was able to take, because it gave me the opportunity to see outside some of the walls of daily teaching that I see, and I'm able to open the doors to see so many other teachers and listen to their journeys, and I'm even more inspired by them and what they have to say to me and the stories that they've shared. And just it makes me recognize that I am so privileged to work with other gifted teachers and the teachers that show the same passion that I do, and that we are all in it together and we're a Keller ISD team.
I've been very fortunate to work with great teams, and I think that Teacher of the Year is really not about that specific teacher, but it's a group of teachers. It's a group that is nurturing children and to let them become what they can become.
Being named State Teacher of the Year meant that I was gone a lot. it was a really humbling experience. I always got mad at people when they had these high honors bestowed upon them, and I talked about how humbling it was, because to me that didn't make sense until it happened to me. And then I realized you start to analyze more about yourself, and I would look around the hallway and see a bunch of teachers that I thought were better than me. So it was a humbling experience. It became something that I was very proud of, and I use it when I need to email parents.
I'll connect with them any way I can. If it's about Pokemon, I'll learn about Pokemon so I can figure out what it is. If they play baseball or football or hockey or volleyball or whatever, I'll go to their games and just have interest in them. If they play guitar or they like music or a certain singer, I'll connect with them. And if you can connect with them, then you can teach them anything, because they, just like everybody else in the world, they just want to be loved and feel like somebody cares about them. So if you can connect with them on any level, then you've got a good start.
Learning has to be fun, especially in my little second grade minds. They're wanting to be the big kids, but they're still the little kids, and just being able to take them as far as I can, whether it's through technology, whether it's through real world experience, whether it's through my own stories, because they know that I'm a real person and they can't believe that certain things happened to me. Building that relationship is huge for them, and they're safe enough to be able to explore. They're able to make mistakes. They're able to laugh at themselves. They're able to laugh at others respectfully. And we're all able to come back on the same page and know that we're all on the same journey moving forward.
My classroom was built on the relationships I had with those kids. It was knowing each and every one of them and understanding that, you know, a student is more than a lesson. And you have to take that into effect and take that into account, sorry, and understand that we all have different things going on in our lives, and if we can't connect with each other personally, then I can't reach that student on a different level. And so I can come in with a great lesson plan, but if that student has something going on at home that I don't know about, it can ruin their entire day, and it makes me feel like my lesson was a failure. So it was really just understanding that the relationships we have, that connectivity that we formed, is what drove the success of our classroom.
A teacher of the year, whatever classroom they come from, is that they're able to connect to every child in the classroom.
Every teacher I know gives a lot of effort in their classroom, and it's seen by their kids every day. But I think what sets maybe teachers of the year apart is they give so much to their classroom that it overflows into the hallways and it overflows outside of school, and other people start to see it too. Principals start to see it and other teachers start to see it. And I think getting that recognition, it's one thing for a kid to tell you that they love you or you're a great teacher, which means the world to you. But when you have your peers start telling you, I appreciate what you do, or it's super special.
Teachers of the year, I know, work hard to, in their daily, everyday academics with their kiddos, have the strongest work ethic, passion for their students, want to reflect the fun inside of the standards, making sure that their learning is complete, making sure that the kiddos are first and foremost and center of everything that they do. But I think all Keller ISD teachers do that, so that's why setting us apart is more of a luck of the draw.
There's something that goes beyond that one year, something that goes beyond a test score or a grade, but a lifetime imprint on them, because they make it on us, they make it on me. You know, I have students that I think about daily on how they're doing, and it's just, I would love to think that thought crosses their mind as well, because we all look back and think of one to two teachers in our lives that stood out. And that's the teacher I want to be. I want to be that teacher that stands out, that they think back and remember, and that one day they're telling their kids about, I had this one teacher.
I want to thank my teacher for teaching me and giving me hugs.
I saw a kid this weekend and he recognized me. Of course, when you have a kid in seventh grade, they look a lot different than they do when they're 21. And he walked up to me and asked me what I did, and I told him I was a teacher, and he goes, Mr. Cornelius. And some way, I don't know, by the grace of God, I remembered his name. And he just looked at me and he said, you're the best teacher I've ever had. You cared about me when nobody else did. And so that's the legacy I would want to leave, because they don't remember learning about photosynthesis or cells or anything, but they remember how you made them feel and, you know, wanting to come to your class. And seventh grade can be tough, and wanting to come to class can make a huge difference. So that's my legacy that I would want them to, or that I would want to leave.
Be proud. I spent most of the year deflecting attention because I didn't want it. And I look back and think that it's something you need to be proud of. We need more people to be honored for what we do. So be proud of it. Take that responsibility and know that this is what your peers have chosen for you. This is why you've been, you know, put on this pedestal for this time frame. And enjoy it.
Enjoy it. Savor it. Learn all you can, observe, keep your eyes peeled and wide open, and just soak in all of the new knowledge you're going to get. You're going to meet so many great people. You're going to be exposed to so many philosophies and inspiring stories, and it's all there to help you grow and to continuously improve in yourself.
It's amazing to be recognized by your peers, because I'm sure, like at my campus, you're surrounded by amazing people. So my advice is to be as honest as you can. Let the world see what you do. Share it all. Don't hold anything back, and let people see how great you are and what you pour into your kids, because it's important. People need to know that.
Let your students be the peak, not this award, but continue this. You know, continue to be the teacher of the year every single year, every single day that you teach.